Hello everyone. Welcome to our channel, Civil Engineering Notes. I hope you all are good. In this video, I will discuss about behavior of cement concrete using alternative materials. You can download the topic in PPT format from our website. I will give the link in the description of the video, and also on the screen. You can also submit your project or presentation by clicking the link in the description, but, before we start, like this video, because we need validation. Share this video, because this video needs more views. Comment on this video, because it will motivate us. Subscribe to the channel, because more videos are coming soon. So, let's begin. Introduction. The requirement of concrete aggregate in India is large, corresponding to current annual production of cement of 300 million tons, total requirement of coarse and fine aggregate for use in cement concrete, mortar and plasters of about 1,500 metric tons per year is a safe estimate. There is difficulty in obtaining natural aggregates within economic distances. Search for alternate sources of aggregates thus assumes importance. One such alternative is recycled concrete aggregate derived from construction and demolition wastes, which allow conservation of natural resources and land. Aggregate in concrete constructions typically account for 75% of the total volume. The majority of concrete constructions till date essentially resort to aggregate materials derived from natural resources conforming to IS 383. However, due to the need of conserving natural resources and issues relating to sustainability, environmental considerations and economy, increasing use of recycled and secondary aggregate has been forecasted. Objectives. First, to compare the compressive strength of recycled coarse aggregate for constructional concrete with the conventional concrete. Second, to know its applications in construction industry. Third, to reduce the pressure on naturally available materials by replacing it with recycled aggregate. Fourth, to compare the physical characteristics of natural aggregate with recycled aggregate. Fifth, to study the behavior of fresh and hardened concrete reinforced with recycled coarse aggregate. Advantages and disadvantages. First, discuss about the advantages. We have the following advantages of using recycled aggregates. 1. It is cost-saving. 2. It is better for controlling alkali-silica reaction. 3. To save environment, recycled aggregates may be used. 4. It save time. 5. It also have less emission of carbon. 6. Up to 20% replacement of natural aggregate with RCA or RMA without a need for additional testing. For all concrete up to a characteristic strength of 65 MPa as per Indian standard is permitted. There are also some disadvantages, such as 1. Less quality. 2. Duration of procurement of materials may affect life cycle of project. 3. Land, special equipment machineries are required. 4. Very high water absorption. 5. It has higher drying shrinkage. Properties of recycled concrete aggregate. Here are some properties which can be seen in recycled concrete. Physical properties of fresh concrete containing RCA. You can saw some physical properties of fresh concrete, which contains RCA, such as workability, water content, air content. Physical properties of hardened concrete containing RCA. Here are some properties of hardened concrete containing RCA, such as compressive strength, flexural strength, modulus of elasticity, durability, bond strength with reinforcement, creep, and drying shrinkage. Quantity of material used in experiment. We used the following quantities of cement, sand, coarse aggregates, and water for slump test. For compressive test with normal aggregates, recycled aggregates, and brick bats, we used the following quantities of cement, sand, coarse aggregates, and water. And, For compressive test with partial replacement of cement with fly ash, we replaced the cement content by 25%, 50%, and 75% in three different samples. Experimental Program 1. First, we conducted specific gravity and water absorption test of aggregates. Specific gravity of an aggregate is a measure of strength or quality of the material. Stones having low specific gravity are generally weaker than those with higher specific gravity. Behavior of concrete by partial replacement of coarse aggregate with recycled plastic granules. Water absorption indicates strength of rocks. Stones having more water absorption are more porous in nature and are unsuitable unless they are found to be acceptable based on strength, impact, and hardness tests. Apparatus used in this test. We need beaker of 1 liter, hot air oven, weighing balance, and a tray for this test. Procedure. First, take about 2 kilograms of coarse aggregate sample, wash thoroughly to remove finer particles and dust and immerse in water for 24 hours at a temperature between 22 degrees Celsius and 32 degrees Celsius with a cover of at least 5 centimeters of water above the top of the basket. Lift the basket 25 millimeters above the base of tank and allowing it to drop 25 times at the rate of more than 1 drop per second. The weight is noted while suspending in water as W1. Then, remove the aggregate from basket and allow it to drain for a few minutes. Weight of empty basket in water is measured as W2. Take out the immersed aggregate and place in a dry cloth. It shall then be spread out not more than 1 stone deep, and best exposed to the atmosphere away from direct sunlight or any other source of heat for not less than 10 minutes, or until it appears to be completely surface dry. Measure weight of the aggregate as W3. Then, the aggregate shall then be placed in the oven in the shallow tray, at a temperature of 100 to 110 degrees Celsius and maintained at this temperature for 24 hours. After 24 hours, it shall then be removed from the oven, and cooled in the airtight container and weighed as W4. Finally, we determine the specific gravity and water absorption values using these formula. In our experiment, we got the following observations. Using these values, we got the following results. Experimental Program 2. Then, we conducted a slump test to determine the workability of the concrete. The concrete slump test is used for the measurement of a property of fresh concrete. The test is an empirical test that measures the workability of fresh concrete. More specifically, it measures consistency between batches. The test is popular due to the simplicity of apparatus used and simple procedure. Principle of slump test. The slump test result is a measure of the behavior of a compacted inverted cone of concrete under the action of gravity. It measures the consistency or the wetness of concrete. Apparatus used. A slump cone, a scale for measurement, and a steel tempying rod. Procedure of concrete slump test. The mold for the slump test is a frustum of a cone of 300 millimeters of height. The base is 200 millimeters in diameter and it has a smaller opening at the top of 100 millimeters. First of all, the base is placed on a smooth surface and the container is filled with concrete in three layers, whose workability is to be tested. Each layer is tempied 25 times with a standard 16 millimeters diameter steel rod, rounded at the end. When the mold is completely filled with concrete, the top surface is leveled with mold top opening by means of screening and rolling motion of the tempying rod. The mold must be firmly held against its base during the entire operation so that it could not move due to the pouring of concrete, and this can be done by means of handles or foot rest spreads to the mold. Then, immediately after filling is completed, and the concrete is leveled, the cone is slowly and carefully lifted vertically, and unsupported concrete will now slump. The decrease in the height of the center of the slumped concrete is called slump. Now, the slump is measured by placing the cone just besides the slump concrete and the tempying rod is placed over the cone so that it should also come over the area of slumped concrete. The decrease in height of concrete to that of mold is noted with scale. It is usually measured to the nearest 5 millimeters. Types of concrete slump. The slumped concrete takes various shapes, and according to the profile of slumped concrete, the slump is termed as collapse slump, shear slump, and true slump. Collapse slump. In a collapse slump, the concrete collapses completely. A collapse slump will generally mean that the mix is too wet or that it is a high workability mix, for which slump test is not appropriate. Shear slump. In a shear slump, the top portion of the concrete shears off and slips sideways, or if one half of the cone slides down an inclined plane, the slump is said to be a shear slump. If a shear or collapse slump is achieved, a fresh sample should be taken and the test is repeated. If the shear slump persists, as may the case with harsh mixes, this is an indication of lack of cohesion of the mix. True slump. In a true slump, the concrete simply subsides, keeping more or less to shape. This is the only slump which is used in various tests. Mixes of stiff consistence have a zero slump, so that in the rather dry range no variation can be detected between mixes of different workability. Depending upon the various slump values, concrete are used in different suitable places. In this table, we can see their uses, for various slump values. Experimental Program 3. Compressive Test of Concrete as per IS 456:2000. Compressive Strength of Concrete Cube Test provides an idea about all the characteristics of concrete. By this single test, one judge that whether concreting has been done properly or not. Concrete compressive strength for general construction varies from 15 MPa to 30 MPa, and higher in commercial and industrial structures. Compressive strength of concrete depends on many factors such as water-cement ratio, cement strength, quality of concrete material, and quality control during production of concrete, etc. Test for compressive strength is carried out either on cube or cylinder. Various standard codes recommend concrete cylinder or concrete cube as the standard specimen for the test. American Society for Testing Materials ASTM C39 and C39 meter provide standard test method for compressive strength of cylindrical concrete specimens. Apparatus for concrete cube test. It just need a compression testing machine for the test. Preparation of concrete cube specimen. The proportion and material for making these test specimens are from the same concrete used in the field. Specimen. To conduct the test, we need cubes of size 15 cm by 15 cm by 15 cm. Preparation of concrete cubes for the test. For cube test, two types of specimens, either cubes of 15 cm or 10 cm, depending upon the size of aggregate, are used. For most of the works, cubical mold of size 15 cm are commonly used. The concrete is poured in the mold, and tempered properly so as not to have any voids. After 24 hours, these molds are removed and test specimens are put in water for curing. The top surface of these specimens should be made even and smooth. This is done by putting cement paste and spreading smoothly on whole area of specimen. These specimens are tested by compression testing machine after 7 days curing or 28 days curing. Load should be applied gradually at the rate of 140 kg per cm square per minute till the specimens fails. Load at the failure divided by area of specimen gives the compressive strength of concrete. Curing of cubes. The test specimens are stored in moist air for 24 hours, and after this period the specimens are marked and removed from the molds, and kept submerged in clear fresh water until takeout prior to test. Procedure for cube test. First, remove the specimen from water after specified curing time and wipe out excess water from the surface. Then, clean the bearing surface of the testing machine. Now, place the specimen in the machine in such a manner that the load shall be applied to the opposite sides of the cube cast. Also, align the specimen centrally on the base plate of the machine. Next, rotate the movable portion gently by hand so that it touches the top surface of the specimen. Then, apply the load gradually without shock and continuously at the rate of 140 kg per cm square per minute till the specimen fails. Finally, record the maximum load, and note any unusual features in the type of failure. It should be noted that, Minimum 3 specimens should be tested at each selected age. If strength of any specimen varies by more than 15% of average strength, results of such specimen should be rejected. Average of 3 specimens gives the crushing strength of concrete. In this table, we can see the compressive strength of concrete at various ages as per Indian standard recommendation. In the second table, we can see the compressive strength of different grades of concrete at 7 days and 28 days. Result of experiments. For the specific gravity and water absorption test of coarse aggregate, we got the following results. We also get the slump value of concrete as 15 millimeters. Compressive strength using normal coarse aggregates, we have the following results. When we replaced some normal coarse aggregates with recycled coarse aggregates, we got the following compressive strength. And when we replaced some normal coarse aggregates with brick bats, we got the following compressive strength. Now, if we compare the compressive strength, we have these values for different coarse aggregates. And here is the graphical representation of the compressive strength using different coarse aggregates. When we replaced the cement content with fly ash, we have the following compressive strength for different percentages of fly ash. Concluding remarks. Recycling and reuse of building wastes have been found to be an appropriate solution to the problems of dumping hundreds of thousands of tons of debris accompanied with shortage of natural aggregates. The use of recycled aggregates in concrete proved to be a valuable building materials in technical, environmental, and economical respect. There are several reliable applications for using recycled coarse aggregate in construction. However, more research and initiation of pilot project for application of RCA is needed for modifying our design codes, specifications, and procedure for use of recycled aggregate concrete. Share this video with your friends on Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp, Instagram, and any other social media. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Telegram, and Pinterest. We are everywhere. Links are in the description. Thanks for watching this video. See you soon.